Hi, everyone. We've got a question from a fellow boater named Matthew. Matthew asks, Jeff, in the past few months, I've been on my boat on a mooring buoy and using a generator, probably a AC generator, although Matthew didn't say it, but let's assume it's an AC generator. Out of nowhere, my AC reverse polarity light came on and hasn't done this before. How do I fix it? Okay, great question from Matthew. First of all, what's a reverse polarity light? And reverse polarity to what? So reverse polarity is a term used to describe a situation with AC systems, so alternating current systems, so like basically generators or shore power systems. Those are AC systems as opposed to battery systems, which are DC direct current systems. Alternating current versus direct. So when we have an alternating current system, 120, 220, whatever it is, aboard a boat, at the main panel, there should be, and most of us have this, a little light. And generally it's labeled, it's reverse polarity, and it's generally red. That little red light measures, literally it's powered between two things. It's powered between the neutral and the AC neutral. So that's what's called the ground connector. And the AC ground, which is called the grounding connector. So it's a light that in all circumstances should really be zero if things are working out perfectly well, because your ground and neutral should always be at the same potential, meaning there should be no voltage differential between the two. Now, when we're connected to shore power systems, let's say, for example, a marina or a destination marina, it does sometimes happen that the electrician who powered the pedestal actually inverted the leads. So the hot is on the neutral and the neutral is on the hot. And if that's the case, if the hot is on the neutral, then the reverse polarity light, which measures a voltage differential between the neutral and the ground, is going to see maybe 120 or 220 volts. And that light will shine brightly, telling you that the neutral was swapped for the hot, telling you that you have reverse polarity and it is serious and should be addressed. Separate videos all on that if you want to geek out. I've talked about it before. All right, so check out reverse polarity on YouTube on our channel or reverse polarity on our website, and there's going to be lots of information and even articles and further videos just on this topic. So now the weird question though is, this is happening from a boat at a mooring ball running a generator, probably AC, and seeing a reverse polarity light. Well, what could happen, that light is not on or off. I know that that's what we expect, but it is possible for a neutral to ground connection to not be that good and to maybe have 5 volts, 7 volts of voltage differential, and for that light to be shining, but very dimly. So what I would say, Matthew, the first thing that I would do, and you need to make sure that you're comfortable doing this or have an electrician do it for you, is I would actually measure with an AC multimeter, but I would measure the voltage differential between the neutral and the ground at my AC panel. And when your generator is running, which is a source of power, that generator should have a good neutral to ground tie, because it's a source of power, not only when it's working, of course, but a generator should be have a what's called a neutral to ground tie, because all sources of power, an inverter, shore power stations, all of that have a neutral to ground tie. So it's possible that your neutral to ground tie on your generator is going, it's not going well, and that's not normal and serious. So you're going to want to make sure that the generator has that really good generator a ground to neutral tie. And you want to measure that. And what you're probably seeing here is some sort of bad connection on your generator. That's what I would guess. But it's probably not reverse polarity, because reverse polarity is not something that randomly happens. It's a wiring issue that is done opposite of what it should be. And it can't flip-flop. If it was straight good polarity a month ago, it's very rare to see a situation where you have reverse polarity, unless there's some sort of wiring mistake where the wires get crossed somehow, and this is, would be very serious. But in normal cases, reverse polarity only is something you uncover right after doing the work. It's not something you're going to uncover suddenly 10 months or 10 years after the work has been done. So to me, it's probably a grounding issue. And a great question from Matthew. And thanks for all of you for tuning in and watching into another Tech Talk. Be safe on the water and let us know what your troubles have been with reverse polarity lights down below. Because remember, sharing is caring. Thanks for watching. So if you're curious again, go on our website and find out more answers and solutions with this sort of setup. And thanks for asking. And thanks for all of you for listening and tuning in.